I welcome you all in the channel Knowledge Thrust. So dear all, in this video we are going to cover some of the important question for the GPAT examinations. So let's start. The question number one: Erythromycin belongs to the class of antibiotics. So the question says, to which chemical class does erythromycin antibiotic belong? Option number A, aminoglycosides. Option number B, macrolides. So erythromycin belongs to the macrolide class of antibiotic. Next question: Kawasaki syndrome is, what is this Kawasaki syndrome? As the name indicates, it's a Japanese name, so it is more prevalent in Japan and Hawaii. Patient show rickettsia like bacteria in the skin biopsies. Strain involved may be Propionibacterium. So answer will be all of these. So let me show you the pic also. As you can see, these are the symptoms related to the Kawasaki disease. Please see the structure of macrolide also. Erythromycin belongs to this class of macrolide. Next question number 3. Main causative organism of gas gangrene. So I will directly show the answer. Clostridium perfringens is the causative organism for the gas gangrene. As you can see, very serious disease, gas gangrene. Next very common question. Causative organism of whooping cough. Yes, Bordella pertussis. So BCG vaccination is also given in respect of whooping cough. Bordella pertussis is the causative organism for whooping cough. Let's see question number 5. The purification and the recovery of the production after fermentation. So fermentation mein do procedure hum use karte hain, upstream or downstream process. So product banne ke baad jo purification ka procedure hai ya to recovery include hai, it is known as a downstream process. और प्यूरिफिकेशन से पहले जब हम फर्मेंटेशन करेंगे उसको फर्मेंटर में डालेंगे, दैट इज नोन एज ए अपस्ट्रीम प्रोसेस. प्लीज सी दिस पिक. अपस्ट्रीम में क्या होगा? सेल लाइन सिलेक्शन, मीडिया प्यूरिफिकेशन, फॉर्मुलेशन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन एंड स्टरलाइजेशन. ओके, तो यहां पे मीडिया प्यूरिफिकेशन की बात की गई है, इसको कंफ्यूज नहीं करना आपने, जो हम बाद में प्रोडक्ट को प्यूरिफाई करेंगे. ओके, और डाउनस्ट्रीम में क्या होगा? हार्वेस्टिंग करेंगे, आइसोलेशन करेंगे, देन प्यूरिफिकेशन, जो प्रोडक्ट आएगा उसकी प्यूरिफिकेशन, देन फॉर्मुलेशन एंड पैकेजिंग, दे ऑल इंक्लूडेड इन द डाउनस्ट्रीम प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ द फर्मेंटेशन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म यूज्ड फॉर अल्कोहल प्रोडक्शन, इज इट सैक्रोमाइसिस सेरेवाइस, बैसिलस सबटिलिस, पेनिसिलिन, क्राइसोजेनम? नो, आंसर विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर ए. सैक्रोमाइसिस सेरेवाइस इज लार्जली यूज्ड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ अल्कोहल इन इंडस्ट्री. सो आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्टनेस ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट, बताइए ट्रू और फॉल्स. Flutamide is not an anti-androgenic drug. No, flutamide or bicalutamide, these are the anti-androgenic drugs. So this statement is false. As you can see, this is a flutamide, also available in the form of capsule. Next statement again. Leothyronin is a thyroid hormone. Okay. Thyroid hormone consists of the iodinated aromatic amino acids and are known steroidal in nature. So yes, this statement is correct, very much correct. So yes, it is also available in the market by the name of the Cytomel, that contains leothyronine 5 microgram. Next again, true and false. HCG, that is known as the human chronic gonadotropic hormone, is produced by the placental tissue and serves to stimulate the secretion of the progesterone during pregnancy. Yes, this statement is very much correct. Next very very important question. Metformin is preferred over fenformin. So I hope you know about metformin and fenformin. These are anti-diabetic drugs, hypoglycemics. Why metformin is preferred? Because it is less liable to cause lactic acidosis. So this is the most appropriate answer over here. As you can see, these are the metformin tablets. And what is lactic acidosis? So isko bhi yaad rakhna hai apne. It is a medical condition characterized by a building up of lactate in the body. और एसिडोसिस क्यों होगा? बिकॉज काफी लो पीएच हो जाएगा ब्लड स्ट्रीम में, तो इट इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ द मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस आल्सो. नाउ प्लीज सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द गेस्टेशनल डायबिटीज वुड कंप्राइज ऑफ, किस तरह की ट्रीटमेंट करेंगे? क्लोप्रोपामाइड, क्लिपिजाइड, इंसुलिन. तो वी विल यूज इंसुलिन फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द गेस्टेशनल डायबिटीज. और ये भी याद रखिए, ये होता क्या है? गेस्टेशनल डायबिटीज इज अ कंडीशन इन विच ब्लड शुगर लेवल्स बिकम हाई ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी. नेक्स्ट प्रेफर रूट ऑफ इंसुलिन, तो इंसुलिन किस रूट से दिया जाता है, ओरल और सबक्यूटेनियस, तो हमें पता है इट इज गिवन बाय सबक्यूटेनियस रूट, एज यू कैन सी, तो दिस इज अ सबक्यूटेनियस इंजेक्शन ऑफ इंसुलिन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द इंसुलिन रिसेप्टर इज व्हाट, टायरोसिन प्रोटीन काइनेज रिसेप्टर और जी प्रोटीन कपल्ड रिसेप्टर, तो इट इज टायरोसिन प्रोटीन काइनेज रिसेप्टर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सीवियर केसेस ऑफ द ब्लीडिंग ड्यू टू फिब्रिनोलिटिक एजेंट्स आर ट्रीटेड विद, तो फिब्रिनोलिटिक एजेंट्स की वजह से अगर ब्लीडिंग हो जाए क्या यूज करते हैं उसके लिए हम, हेपेरिन और एप्सिलॉन अमीनो कैप्रोइक एसिड इज द आंसर. वी यूज ईएसीए इन केसेस ऑफ सीवियर ब्लीडिंग ड्यू टू फिब्रिनोलिटिक एजेंट्स. प्लीज सी दिस, दिस इज द अमीनो कैप्रोइक एसिड इंजेक्शंस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, पाइरिडॉक्सिन गिवन टू द पेशेंट ऑफ टीबी इट विल प्रिवेंट, दैट इज आइसोनियाज़िड induced peripheral neuritis or rifampicin induced hepatotoxicity, answer will be INH, that is isoniazid induced peripheral neuritis. So pyridoxine vitamin is given in patient suffering with TB. So please read this, peripheral neuropathy hai kya, it is a rare adverse effect associated with the isoniazid anti-TB drug very commonly used and it is occurs after the prolonged use of drug. अब टीबी के केसेस में हमें डॉट्स थेरेपी करने पड़ती है, काफी लंबे समय के लिए ड्रग कंज्यूम करने पड़ती है, तो कई बार हमें साइड इफेक्ट्स हो जाते हैं, तो इसीलिए हम इसके साथ साथ पाइरिडॉक्सिन सप्लीमेंटेशन भी देते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज प्रोलैक्टिन, सो इफ प्रोलैक्टिन इज लो कैन कॉज इनफर्टिलिटी इन वुमेन एंड इफ प्रोलैक्टिन कैन सुप्रेस द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल, यस दिस इज द राइट आंसर, प्रोलैक्टिन कैन सुप्रेस द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल इन lactating woman. A main function kya hai prolactin ka, basically it is a milk ejecting hormone, it is a hormone produced by your pituitary gland and it causes breast to grow and develop and causes milk to be made after a baby is born. So prolactin ka apne is tarah se yaad rakhna hai. Next question, leothyronine is the drug of choice in the treatment of myxoedema, myxoedema coma or cretinism. So answer will be myxoedema. Please read this condition. Hota kya hai isme? In myxoedema coma is a loss of the brain function as a result of the severe long standing low dose of the thyroid hormone in the blood. Jiski wajah se ye myxoedema coma ki conditions aa jati. Next question, antibiotics, sulfonamide and trimethoprim combination. It become bactericidal because we know sulfonamide inhibit the conversion of the PABA to folic acid and trimethoprim from folic acid to folinic acid. Please see this, sulfonamide kya kar raha hai yahan pe, ye block kar raha hai isko, okay, means it block the conversion of the para amino benzoic acid PABA ko dihydrofolic acid mein convert nahi hone dega sulfonamide. And see the trimethoprim mechanism of action, it will block this enzyme, that is the dihydrofolate reductase, jiski wajah se dihydrofolic acid will not convert into tetrahydrofolic acid aur is tarah se DNA purines nahi banenge. To jo bhi bacteria ke andar hai, DNA mechanism block ho jayega, kisi bhi tarah ke purine DNA synthesis nahi hogi, bacteria cell action achieved. Next question, again a repeated question I think, isoniazid may cause peripheral neuropathy and anemia as its side effect because we know it interferes with the pyridoxine metabolism and induces its deficiency. इसलिए हमें pyridoxine उन patients को देने पड़ेगी जो भी isoniazid पे हैं. Next, prolonged chlorpromazine therapy results in, अगर कोई लंबे समय के लिए chlorpromazine drug ले तो क्या होगा? Osteomalacia और photosensitivity. तो yes, option will be option number A. तो what is osteomalacia? It refers to the softening of the bones and caused by severe vitamin D deficiency. और chlorpromazine क्या है? Antipsychotic drug है. So next question, the drug used for the cervical priming to facilitate labor induce करने के लिए हम prostaglandin E2 use करते हैं. तो here it is, prostaglandin E2, that is also known as the dinoprostone. Okay, it is used in the labor induction. Here it is also available in the form of gels now. Question number next, what is the basic principle involved in thin layer chromatography? Yes, adsorption will be the answer. Surface phenomena. okay, and what is absorption? Bulk phenomena. Next, again related to TLC, in thin layer chromatography is performed on a sheet of the glass, plastic or aluminium foil, okay, which is coated with a thin layer of the adsorbent material such as silica, gel, aluminium oxide. Yes, this statement is correct. Yes, very much. Next question, please identify the reaction. What reaction it is? This is very simple reaction, that is known as the Reimer-Thymer reaction. Very simple reaction, phenol is treated with chloroform in the presence of potassium hydroxide. So we can say, when phenols are treated with chloroform in the presence of NaOH or KOH, jiski wajah se hua kya, an aldehyde group, that is CHO, is introduced at the ortho position of the benzene ring. Benzene ring ki ortho position pe CHO group aayega, jiski wajah se formation hogi ortho hydroxybenzaldehyde ki. Identify kijiye kya structure hai ye. This one structure is salbutamol. Yes, widely used in asthma in the form of inhaler mein bhi isko hum bahut yaad use karte hain. Please see the image. This is the asthaline inhaler that contains salbutamol. And always remember one thing, it is a short acting beta 2 adrenergic receptor agonist drug. Next question, identify this structure. This is the structure of the carbamazepine, very very important drug. So yes, again anti epileptic drug, that is the carbamazepine, or also used in the convulsions, anticonvulsant also. Now identify this structure. This is a structure of tetracycline. So yes, this antibiotic is used to treat many bacterial infection of the skin, intestine, respiratory tract, UTI, including the genitals, lymph nodes and other systems of the body. So very commonly used antibiotic, tetracycline. Next question, the major beneficial effect of nitrates in the classical angina is due to. So nitrate is the most important benefit. Kya hai? It dilates the veins more than arteries. So remember this thing. Dilation of veins more than arteries. And what happened in angina? It is a type of the chest pain caused by reduced blood flow to the heart. Angina pectoris is the name. And generally, the organic nitrates can dilate both arteries and veins. Next question, digoxin differ from digitoxin in that digoxin, its half-life is more dependent on the adequacy of the renal function. This is the correct option, option number A. Next question, the GTN, that is a glyceryl trinitrate, is generally taken as oral route, intravenous or sublingual. The answer will be option number C. It is taken at sublingual route. These are the tablets, GTN tablets, and used as a sublingual. Please see this image. This is the buccal route. Agar hum tongue ke upar rakhenge drug ko, or this is the sublingual. Is tongue ke lingual part mein niche hum rakhenge. It is the sublingual route. As you can see, this is the sublingual region. So next question, methemoglobinemia can occurs with high doses of. So with high doses of the nitrates, a condition occurs which is, yes, methemoglobinemia. It is a condition of the elevated methemoglobin in the blood. Blood ke andar methemoglobin bahut zyada increase ho jayega, jiski wajah se kuch symptoms aayenge jaise headache, dizziness, shortness of the breath, nausea, poor muscle coordination, and also the blue colored skin. This is a main symptom that is known as the cyanosis. Simple bhasha mein bol sakte hain, haathon ka neela pad jana. Next question, perhexylene malleate is a which type of drug? It is very commonly used vasodilator drug. Next question, reserpine obtained from the Rowolfia plant is used in the hypertension only in low doses because the side effects become disproportionately marked. It marked increase the side effect, so we have to use the reserpine in very small dose. As you can see, this is the reserpine which contains indole nucleus. It is an indole alkaloid drug. Very important question, which of the following is not a calcium channel blocker? Options are verapamil, diltiazem, then option number D is Propranolol is the right answer. This is the beta blocker and it is not the calcium channel blocker. Next, chronic use of nitrates may lead to, it may lead to tolerance in the body. If we use nitrates excessively or the increase the dose of the nitrate, it may lead to the tolerance in the body. Next, activation of the prothrombin to thrombin is carried out by which factor? Factor number 5. Please see this, prothrombin to thrombin, factor 5 is involved. Next question, which of the following is a steroidal antibiotic? The answer will be fusidic acid. This is a very commonly used steroidal antibiotic. So nowadays also available in the form of cream. Next question, why benzyl penicillin is ineffective in gram-negative condition or gram-negative infections? The answer is very simple. The lipoprotein peptidoglycan cell wall of the gram-negative organisms prevent entry of penicillin. Here it is, that is the gram-negative cell wall. It is a peptidoglycan layer over here, and here these are the lipoproteins. Next question, the general test for detection of the carbohydrate, very simple, Mollisch test, in which alpha naphthol is used. Next, 42 question, the enzyme catalyzing electron transport are present mainly in the where the enzymes which catalyze electron transport reaction, it is present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. As you can see, this is the inner mitochondrial membrane which contain these enzymes which involved in the electron transport. Next question, the principal light trapping pigment molecule in the plants, algae and the cyanobacteria is, answer will be chlorophyll A. Next question, disease that affect many countries or many people at different countries is termed that pandemic. So COVID condition is there, pure vishwa mein COVID spread ho chuka hai, it become a pandemic. So please remember this thing, epidemic is a disease that affect a large number of population or people within a particular community, population or a region. अगर वो COVID A की जगह तक सीमित होता तो हम उसे epidemic बोलते हैं, वो पहले epidemic बना, धीरे धीरे वो pandemic बन गया, पूरी दुनिया में फैल गया. There is another condition that is known as the endemic. तो endemic is something that belongs to a particular people or a country, जिसमें सिर्फ एक particular class के ही लोगों को affect करेगा, that is the endemic. लेकिन अगर उसी कंट्री में बहुत ज़्यादा लोग इफेक्ट होने लग जाएंगे, इट बिकम द एपिडेमिक. अगर पूरी दुनिया में उसका स्प्रेड हो जाएगा, दैट बिकम अ पेंडेमिक. इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप डिस्कवर्ड बाय, आंसर विल बी रस्का एंड नोल. दीज आर द टू साइंटिस्ट विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर पेशेंट लिसनिंग. सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास.